Hey everyone, I'm Carissa Wiley at sprinkledwithglitter.com and licensed designer for Spellbinders. I'm here today to give you some tips and tricks for using the new Disco Impressions Press Play and Coordinating Die Set. Now, when we designed this press play set, we designed the coordinating dies to cut perfectly around the outline, and sometimes that can be a little tricky. So I'm going to give you some tips and tricks for aligning these dies today. So here is a look at the Disco Impressions Press Play and Coordinating Die Set. You can see you get three different size disco balls, and these are press plates, which means you can use them with either your Glimmer Hot Foil system or your BetterPress Letterpress system. These coordinating dies are designed to cut directly around the pressed area or the foiled area, and I want to show you how to get perfect cuts every time. I pre-foiled each of these press plate designs onto some light gray cardstock. You can see that beautiful foil there. And I'm going to die cut these out, and I'm going to give you a tip for getting these perfectly aligned. So you're going to find that when you align the dies, that they are going to align perfectly with the outside edge. But because a little bit of the overlap from the die can kind of throw your eye off just a little, I'm going to show you how you can line these up and cut them perfectly every time. So I'm starting here with a lightweight or a couple lightweight pieces of cardstock. So you don't want anything too thick for this. And I'm just going to die cut each of these from this thin white cardstock. I'm using my Spellbinders Platinum 6 today. And I'll just go ahead and go over the top with my C cutting plate and run these through. Now these are going to serve as our guides for aligning our dies. And that's why we want to use a little bit lighter weight cardstock here. It's also helpful if you use a contrasting color of cardstock from what you foiled or pressed on. So now that I've run these through, I now have kind of this guide that I can align with my press designs and use that to help me position my dies perfectly. Now I like to trim these down because that means they're easier for me to store, because I can use this guide over and over again when I'm using my layered Disco Impressions set. Now, one tip I want to share with you is if you don't have a contrasting color of cardstock, you can cut these out of the same cardstock, and then you can use a marker to kind of trace around the edge of that opening to give your eye a little bit of contrast so that you can see exactly where you're putting this. So now that I have my guide prepared, I am going to look down through the opening in this cardstock piece, and I'm going to line it up where I can see that disco ball perfectly centered, and you can see how close the die line on this really is. Then I'm going to grab some of my best ever craft tape here, and I'm going to hold this guide in place onto the cardstock. I can go ahead and repeat that process with my other sizes. I may have to trim out this smaller disco ball at a different time because I don't want to create impressions in my cardstock. But once again, with this medium disco ball, I am just aligning this to where I can see the edges perfectly in that opening. And once I have my guides in place, I'm going to grab the coordinating die, and I'm just going to kind of slide this in till I feel it lock into that guide. You'll kind of feel it just kind of drop into the open area. And once you have that positioned where you want it, then you can hold it in place again with a little bit of tape while you run that through your die cut machine. So I'm going to do it again here. You can see that when I get it kind of into place, you'll feel it kind of just nest right into the open area of the guide that you've created. And then you can hold that in place and run that through your die cut machine. So now that I've run this through my die cut machine, I can pop out my die cut pieces, and you can see I have a perfectly die cut disco ball with that design all the way up to the edge. I haven't lost any of my design. And then I can repeat the process for the smaller disco ball as well. Keep in mind, these guides can be used over and over again, so I like to store them in the back of my storage envelope for my press plate and die set so that I have them ready to go when I'm ready to create. So I'll show you this process once again with this small disco ball. I am using the guide that I created from some thin cardstock, and I'm looking through the open area of that guide, which is the negative of the die cut piece, and just making sure I can see the entire design of my disco ball. Once I get that into place, I'm going to hold my guide in place with a little bit of repositionable tape, and I'll take the die and kind of wiggle it around until I feel it fall into place in the opening of that guide. Then I'm gonna use another piece of tape to hold that die in place as I run it through my die cut machine. Now that I've run it through my die cut machine, I can just pop it out of my paper and I have a perfectly die cut disco ball. Now here is a card example that I've created using the Disco Impressions press plate and coordinating die set, along with the layered Disco Impressions stencil set. And you can see how those disco balls are just cut perfectly up to the very edge of that design. I love the look that this gives, and I hope that these tips and tricks have helped you for creating with these brand new Disco Impressions press plates. Thanks for joining me here in my craft room today for these tips and tricks featuring the brand new Disco Impressions press plate and coordinating die set from Carissa Wiley and Spellbinders. I can't wait to see what you all create with it. Don't forget to tag me on social media so I can check out what you're creating. And don't forget to shine bright. Thanks for joining me. And until next time, I hope you have a fabulous day.